we are going into February now and coming out of January, coming out of the New Year's. Into February now, there was a celebration done by the Romans called the Lupercalia. And the Lupercalia was based upon their gods of Pan and Juno. They also, February is actually named after one of their gods as well. And so this is a time where you're coming out of the winter and you're going toward the spring season. And so they used to have large gatherings of young people, and they would take the name of women, put them in a large container, and the men would choose them and literally have a sexual relationship. So it was based upon this, you know, Cupid concept. The Greek word is eros, erotica. Okay, so erotica is basically sexuality that pushed the people towards a loose, open sexual relationship. And so that was the main issue on this occasion. And this is where you get Cupids from and hearts and things like that. What happened was they combined this with an individual named Valentine, who in the Roman times, in the third century of the Roman era, he was protecting young people. The Romans said no marriage because we want men to fight strong in battle, so we're not going to let you get married. Valentine, you know, a religious priest, he is an innocent person who's protecting young people and wanting them to get married according to the rules of the church. He disagreed with this. They put him in jail. He went against the state. Eventually, they executed him. And on the day of his execution, he wrote a letter to two of the young people getting married, and he said, "From your Valentines." He's Saint Valentine's. So they took the concept of the open sexuality, put the name of a Christian priest on it, so it seems like a holy day. It seems like it's innocent. It's like they say, a wolf in sheep's clothing, meaning that it appears to be innocent on the outside because Valentine was protecting young people. But actually, it's the open sexuality of the Lupercalia. It is an occasion where more people commit fornication and adultery, where rape happens. If you look at the amount of abortions and so-called unwanted pregnancies, this is a sad case in terms of what is happening in society. And what it is leading to is a society that has no limits, that where modesty is gone and where respect for the family is gone, not only is it going against, you know, the law of God, but secondly, it creates sexually transmitted diseases. It is one of the big problems and plagues in the world today when people do not organize their life, take responsibility for their sexuality. There's a lot of damage that actually comes along with it, especially for the women. The problem is that the socialization, that the society itself teaches people how to take it a step further. Today, erotica is an overriding concept. And so when they watch the television programs or movies, every movie they're fallen in love, even cartoons. Why? Erotica. And that is the dangerous thing for Muslims and people of conscience. So therefore, we're saying to Muslims, don't play around with the devil. Because what is happening is that young people are being fooled into focusing their life on their sexuality, as opposed to focusing their life on their education, on their physical fitness, and then grow into their sexuality. This is how societies develop themselves over the centuries. And when we look at the Quran, it tells us, وَلَا تَقْرَبُ الزِّنَا إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاهِشَةً وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا. The Quran, the last testament, says, do not come close to fornication and adultery, because it is an abomination, and it will destroy everything in the path. Now, other sins, do not kill, do not steal, do not be jealous of your neighbor. You know, Allah says, don't do it. وَلَا تَقْتُلُ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. Don't kill innocent people. But when it comes to adultery and fornication, Allah didn't say, don't commit adultery. He said, don't come near adultery. And so a man is naturally attracted to a woman. A woman is attracted to a man. So that's why Allah said, don't come near it, because it's something that we want to do. We are built to do that in order for the species, you know, to maintain itself. So therefore, what Islam is saying is that yes, have sexuality, but do it within the confines of marriage. Do it in an organized fashion where the man respects the woman, where the family is set up, you know, where he takes care of his children and how people can protect themselves and how sexuality can actually be a beautiful thing. It can be a halal, permissible thing and not something wild and uncontrolled. And you'll find there are groups in Christianity and Judaism and other religions that know about the history of the Lupercalia. They know this. And they also are protecting themselves because this is the basis in all upstanding religions, you know, to protect the family, to protect the sexuality, and therefore you protect society.